The 2023-24 NHL season is going to be a make-or-break year for a lot of players. Some are players entering the league for the first time, ready to make their mark on the NHL. Others are players on the last year of their current contracts looking to prove themselves and get a big payday in the offseason. And some still are players who have just signed massive contracts and now have the pressure of the fans, expecting them to earn all that money. Ignoring the players that are undoubtedly going to be feeling pressured to win the Stanley Cup, we will talk more about them when the playoffs come around. These are the five players I think are under the most pressure to perform during the regular season. And we'll start off with the player who undoubtedly is going to have the most scrutiny and spotlight on him in the 23-24 NHL season, rookie sensation Connor Bedard. This guy was put under a microscope from basically the moment that the draft lottery began, and once he went to the Chicago Blackhawks, everybody began envisioning him leading the Blackhawks to another dynasty run, just like they had with Taves and Kane in the 2010s, and maybe even eclipsing those heights. And those are the expectations that are going to be in place when you are a prospect who has been talked about on the level of guys like Connor McDavid and Sidney Crosby. And those two guys both lived up to the hype. Crosby had 102 points in his first NHL season, and McDavid was a point-a-game player in 45 games with Edmonton before going out for the rest of the year with a shoulder injury. Both of those players failed to win the Calder Trophy because of injury for McDavid, and because Crosby was going up against the absolute unit that was Alex Ovechkin in his rookie year, so the expectation is probably going to be that Bedard is in that same stratosphere when it comes to his first-year production. Fans are going to be expecting 70 points and 30 goals right out of the gate, or else they're going to be talking about whether he deserves to be in that same conversation that he's been in since he was on skates, basically. And that's a lot of pressure, especially having to do it in the shadow of a longtime face of the franchise and captain, Jonathan Taves, who just announced that he is leaving Chicago. High expectations, plus following the footsteps of a legend, Connor Bedard is going to be tested immediately to find out whether he has the fortitude to deal with the pressure of the NHL. Cole Caufield is another guy I think is under a ton of pressure for a different reason. He's also a young player like Bedard, but he just signed a massive extension with Montreal in the offseason, keeping him in a Habs uniform for the next 8 years at a cap hit of $7.85 million a year. That is a massive investment in a player who has yet to play a full NHL season and has never eclipsed 30 goals in a year. Yes, he had 26 goals in 46 games last year, but he needed shoulder surgery in January 2023, which caused him to miss half of the season. Caufield is getting paid comparably to guys like Jason Robertson in Dallas and Detroit's Alex DeBrincat. Both of these are 40 goal scorers in the NHL already before they got their big payday, and that's not even mentioning the guys he's making more of, players like Clayton Keller, Elias Pettersson, and Dylan Cousins, all players who have eclipsed 30 goals and even 100 points in some cases. So if Cole Caufield doesn't put together a full season where he is scoring around 30 goals and probably 80 points, people are going to start to question whether that contract has any value and whether Caufield has the longevity to be an elite NHL player like he's being paid for. But Caufield's not the only Montreal Canadian who's under a ton of pressure this year. Former number one overall pick and forward Juraj Slafkovsky is going to be under incredible scrutiny this year for a myriad of reasons, not the least of which being that he is a former number one overall pick in one of the most rabid hockey markets in the world. Slafkovsky played in 39 games for Montreal last year, amassing only 4 goals and 10 points, which already has some Canadiens fans a little bit nervous. Now, he was sort of a controversial first overall pick, as a lot of Habs fans assumed that they would be taking Shane Wright at the number one overall slot, but with such a weak performance in his first year, he's going to undoubtedly draw comparisons to Wright, Logan Cooley, Simo Nimich, and any of the other players from this or last year's draft. If he does not perform, the Montreal fans are going to be relentless, and that term bust might be getting thrown around very, very quickly. Now, shifting away from the younger players, let's go to a guy who's actually in the final year of his contract and is going to be looking to get a massive payday next year and potentially get traded at the deadline, Winnipeg Jets goalie Connor Hellebuyck. Now, Hellebuyck is set to headline the free agent goalie class in 2024, which is not a very deep class, so he is probably going to be getting paid a good amount of money regardless. However, just how much he's going to get paid and where he could end up is going to largely be determined by how well he plays this year. Everybody knows the Jets are rebuilding, they don't have much of a defense in front of him, he's going to be facing a lot of shots this year. The question for most GMs in the NHL is going to be, how well does he respond and how much does his save percentage dip? The guy is clearly motivated to get out of Winnipeg, and how well he plays could accelerate that process by leading to a trade either during the season or at the deadline. But on top of that, the fact that Connor Hellebuyck is so eager to leave Winnipeg is going to put a target on his back from mostly his own fans, and from the national media. He's going to be the goalie that people are tracking throughout the season towards the deadline and into free agency. All the offseason speculation will be around him. And to be honest, in Winnipeg, he kind of got to avoid some of that spotlight, so the question is going to be, with the lights turned up on him, and him playing for a big contract next year, how is he going to fare? And last but not least, we have the player who I think is under the most pressure of anybody entering the 23-24 NHL season. A guy who not only got paid big, but whose team had to give up a king's ransom to get him, pun intended. That would be Connor Hellebuck's former teammate and current LA King, Pierre Luc Dubois, who just got paid an 8-year, $68 million contract, an average annual value of $8.5 million. And not only did the Kings have to pay him, they had to give up assets to acquire him. The Kings traded away forwards Gabriel Vilardi, Alex Iafallo, and Rasmus Kupari, along with the second round pick of the 24 NHL draft, to acquire Pierre Luc Dubois. And maybe that's not the biggest haul that a team could have gotten for such a talented young forward, but given the fact that the Kings gave up assets and gave up a lot of money and cap space to him, Pierre Luc Dubois is under pressure to perform to that contract this year. And to be honest, there's risk that the LA Kings bought high on Pierre Luc Dubois after two career years where he scored 60 and 63 points and 28 and 27 goals. This is also for a guy who very famously and in a very ugly manner forced his way out of Columbus to go to Winnipeg a couple of years ago. But he's getting paid around the same as 30 and 40 goal scorers like Mika Zibanejad, Philip Forsberg, Timo Meier, and even Leon Draisaitl. The Kings clearly hope he is going to be able to develop and become more of the offensive leader than he was in Winnipeg, but this is a guy who has so far only produced 60 points at his peak, but you're paying him like a 70 or 80 point player at a minimum. I mean, if Dubois does not pick up his pace and only ends this year with 65 points, this contract is going to be looking like a massive bust right at the beginning. And if those attitude problems from Columbus resurface, who knows, Pierre-Luc Dubois could continue his trend of only being on a team for a few years before getting shipped out again. But if you think these players are the only ones under pressure, think again. The coaches are under even more pressure, and some of them could be coaching for their jobs this year, so check out that video that I made right here.